guys, today I would like to show you how to create a so-called Reese sound or Reese bassline inside Bitwig or any other DAW. If you own Bitwig, you can use the Bully synth as usual, but you can also use any other subtractive synth with at least two oscillators. We need at minimum two voices. I already loaded up one Bully synth in here. And we need to set the first oscillator to saw wave, and you can do that by turning these knobs here. But I think by default it's already set to saw wave. And the trick is now to mix the second saw wave to tune against the first one. So switch this to saw wave, mix in the second oscillator, bring it down to the right octave, and then slowly detune it. Or you can use the multi-voice function of oscillator 2. Whether you place the second oscillator one octave higher or lower depends on your taste, so do it as you like. You should also switch the Bully synth into monophony mode, so that the voices don't overlap. For example, if you have long release times, this will not cause unpleasant overlaps. So it's pretty perfect for bass sounds. The Bully synth also features a glide slider that slips no transitions, very useful in this case. So try to use it. All you have to do now is add random effects to fatten up the sound. For instance, you can use the drive knob. Or you can use the shaper. Or you can try to change the oscillator blend mode, which defines how these two oscillators are mixed together. And last but not least, you can add effects in the chain behind the Bully synth. So in this case, maybe from our last tutorial, our soft clip.
No.
As you can see, with one polysynth and one empty vise, there are already so many possibilities. So don't forget to play around with our parameters until it sounds right for you and your taste. Because it all depends on you and what you want to achieve. One last tip for this tutorial is, if you want to have mono compatibility in the low end, then try to use the FX2 multiband container, which separates your chain into low end and high end. Set the crossover frequency to 100 Hz. So we have everything below 100 Hz in this container and everything above in this container. And then add one tool device in the low end container and set the width parameter to 0. So we have a mono signal in the low end and a stereo signal in the high end, which is pretty nice. Of course, you can add all kinds of effects in the high end container, maybe reverbs, delays, and so on. So try to be creative. Here we have a project I created last night, and I want to show you how such a Reese bassline can sound in a song context. In this case, I used the polysynth, like we did in our tutorial before, and only one amp device and a small EQ to remove some frequencies. In this case, it's 100 Hz where the bass drum is hitting, so I want to have removed that. So let's take a listen. So that's it for now. I hope you learned something. Please leave me a like, leave a subscription, or try to support me on Patreon. It's always appreciated. Thank you for watching, and until next time, bye.